Today I come to declare over your life, the devil, you remain under your feet. You will possess everything that is belong to you. If you are the one, can I hear a loud amen? Now, for today, number one, if you want to dominate and to make the devil to be under your feet, number one, obedience to the word of God. Obedience. Obedience. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Bible says, obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience. A person that obey God is a person that see victory. Remember about Jesus. Jesus, is all his life, he was obedience. And for that reason, when Jesus arrived in front of the tomb of Lazarus, he said, Father, for me, you I know you always answer me. But if I pray, praise the Lord, this for these people. And the word Jesus, he said, Lazarus, come forth. I come to declare over your life as you are the sound of my voice. I declare by the Spirit of God, any area that things was touched in your life, by the, hallelujah, by your obedience, I declare things will be easy for you. The devil always fear the people that they obey God. Because when you are obeying God, the devil will start to obey you. When you obey God, you become under the authority or under the umbrella of the Almighty God. Look about what the Bible says. Obedience, it will cause you to possess your land. Bible shows us about something in Deuteronomy 28. Look all, hallelujah, if you obey the word of the Lord. Look all this blessing that will follow you. Bible says, you'll be the head and the know the tail. So obedience positions you to the realm of authority. The lands, hallelujah, you obey you. Hallelujah. As long as you obey the one that is dominating the planet. Hallelujah. The devil sometimes gives some people certain advantage, certain dominion, certain power to deceive them. Why? Because the devil is after their soul. It's true. He can give certain people some influence. Sometimes the devil can give some people some power to kill innocent people. And the person, he think like he's Elohim. He think like he can't die one day. But we are serving a God. When you obey him, you are under his umbrella. And the authority of our Lord Jesus Christ become your authority. Friend, I come to declare as you are the sound of my voice. I declare, may the authority of the Almighty God become what? Your authority. Look about Jesus. Jesus was unstoppable. Why? Because there was one secret that was with Jesus. And it's the same secret that was with Joseph. Obedience. 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 And what remove, hallelujah, Saul for be a king? Because Saul didn't obey the instruction of the Lord. Saul was a good king. But by simple instruction, the power to dominate the planet disappeared from him. The power to dominate, hallelujah, praise the Lord. The area that God gave to him, that power disappeared. Let me say to you, when that power disappears from you, it does mean like your position disappears. Are you hearing somebody? He was a king, but he was powerless king. Hallelujah. That's why Goliath could stand and challenge the God of Israel, and Saul could not confront, hallelujah, Goliath. There are some people, power was there, but it's not there anymore. Why? Because, hallelujah, obedience is not there. But when you obey God, I promise you, things will be easy for you. I come to declare over your life, that dream of, hallelujah, of property, you will have it. I can't tell you a lot of amen. You will touch it with your hand. You will see it with your eyes. You walk, hallelujah, there. Why? Because when you obey God, nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. When you obey God, the devil will obey you. When you obey God, I promise you, the demon that are controlling this land, those demons, they obey you. Let me say to you, if somebody said to you, life is easy, it's deceiving you. Open a small shop. Sell small things outside here. you will see like there are some people that are controlling the land. They are controlling the streets. It's open a small shop. Sell whatever things. Just play. Try to play with your money. Open a shop. Rent a shop. Sell anything. Even vegetable. In the shop. You will see that, like, there is some people that they already decide like this corner to this corner is mine. And then those people is the people that you can even push him like this. He don't have six packs. He can't run, but he's controlling. Friend, I come to declare over your life as you are obeying God. May the devil leave every territory that is belong to you. Number two, when you are obeying God, the devil will fear you. When you are obeying God, you start to terrorize the enemy. You start to terrorize the enemy. What kill other people will never kill you. They put, hallelujah, Daniel in the, hallelujah, Amanda of the lion. The lion fear to eat, hallelujah, hallelujah, Daniel. It's not everybody that the devil can destroy. Bible says the devil is like a lion. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. What he's doing? He's looking. Who you gonna do what? Devil. So that means even like when he become for attack, the devil is not attack everybody. I can't hear you like that, man. Even when he's an attack, the devil is not attack everybody. And you know the strategy of the devil. The devil is look, he always look the area that you are weak. Is that area that you attack? The area that you are not mature. Is that area that the devil, he will go in that area. That's why the devil, he tries to deceive you when you are disobey God. In that area that you disobey God, he will enter to that area to start to destroy. Because the devil can't come in front of you and challenge you if you are obeying God, because you know he already lose the battle. As he's coming, the presence of the Almighty God, it will make him powerless. Remember about some people that they think like they was, hallelujah, in the position of God. They think like they could destroy Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. They put the fire. Praise the Lord. But we see about what happened. The fire killed them. And the Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, they enter in the fire. It's like they enter in the room. Dancing there and leaving the fire. Friend, I come to declare over your life, what kill other people will never kill you. I can't hear you like the amen. What stress other people will never stress you. Every problem, let me say to you, every problem that you are facing right now, God will use it as an opportunity for you to go higher in life. Some problem that you went through, I promise you, through that problem, you come out with a business deal. If you are the one, can I hear you like that? Never forget, your problem can be a business opportunity. Amen. When you have a conversation with somebody, his problem can be a business opportunity. Glory be to God. Your problem that you are going through, it can be a business opportunity. That's why don't allow your problem to crush you. You put your emotion in front of your problem. God, teach me. You are my God. You cry, after you cry, God, what I need to do? That was the story of David. After he cried because the land was destroyed, Bible shows about something. He inquired from the Lord. The talk of others can destroy you. What your experience of the past can destroy your confidence. People, they have something to talk. You excel, they say you're a cult person. You buy things, they say, look, he's doing multi. Glory be to God. You are not excel, they say, he's finished. People, they will always talk. Hallelujah. David didn't look about what people they were talking about. Okay, let's kill him, we'll kill him. No, that was not his problem. His problem was, God, let my pen flash out. And the number two, show me what I need to do. This season, by the Spirit of God, God will show you what you need to do. If you are the one, can I hear a ladder? Amen. I say, God will show you what you need to do. And then you will do it by the Spirit of the living God. Hallelujah. Job chapter 36, verse 11. Praise the Lord. Bible say, hallelujah. If you obey him and serve him, what you see, hallelujah, what you see, hallelujah. Glory be to God. If you obey him and serve him, hallelujah. One thing you will do, you will prosper. So when you obey God and serve him, because obedience and service going together. Every time I obey God, I'm serving him. I can't tell you like that, man. You can't say, I serve God, I'm not obeying him. No, it doesn't work like that. Service and obedience are working together. Service and obedience are working together. And anything that God asks you to do, he already gives you the capacity. God can ask you something that is bigger than you. No. Anything that God asks you to do, he already gives you the capacity. When God is saying, for example, you must pay the tithe, God already gives you the capacity. But the problem is this, you are looking to your ability. If you want to move from the level of people to manipulate you, start to obey the word of God. Start to obey the word of God. I promise you, God will remove manipulation. Number two, if you want to possess the land, number two, be a lover of God's word. Be a lover of God's word. Be a lover of God's word. The true prophecy of all time. Every prophecy that we profess, we need to find root in the word of God. Somebody called me yesterday. They said, Pastor, I went to different places. They said, Laka, they see me. Hallelujah. They see somebody's coming to marry me. Praise God. But the person, she's already married. I say, what is going on? You're already married. You're already married. Why you need another marriage? Glory be to God. You don't need it. You don't need another marriage. What you need to do is to pray for your husband to remain alive. Are you tired of your husband? No. Hallelujah. It's not scripture. I can't tell you like the man. If you obey the word of God, you become a lover of the word of God. You'll be a winner in life. If you are the one, can I hear him? Amen. Benefit of the word of God. Hallelujah. Number one, the word of God brings light and understanding. The word of God brings what? Light and understanding. So that means the word of God removes confusion from your life. It's removed every form of confusion in your life. And this gives you understanding. And the way there is understanding, there is what? Discernment. I can't tell you like that, man. Where there is what? Understanding, there is what? Discernment. And we know, like what you are talking about is not right, when I have understanding in certain area. Amen? If they say like Jesus died in the water, you have understanding where Jesus died, he died where? On the cross. So because of that, you have understanding, and for that reason, you have what? Discernment on that topic. Hear me, somebody. There is some topic in your life, some area in your life. The devil is still confused you. Why? Because you are not a lover of the word of God. When you become a lover of the word of God, your life is like a chapter of books. Hallelujah. Your life is like a department in the company. Every department is necessary. Every department is complement. In the company, the administration control everything. But the administration is not one department. The administration is everything. Are you hearing somebody? So that is your life. The understanding of things is what makes you a winner in life. I come to declare over your life, may you receive light. May you receive understanding. And then may you operate in what? In discernment. Hallelujah. If the devil is arrived this season with the spirit of death, that spirit of death will go back to sender. I can't hear your ladder. Amen. John chapter 1, verse 1 to 5. John chapter 1, 1 to 5. It shows you something. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Psalm 119, verse, hallelujah, 169. Psalm 119, verse 169. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Say in the name of Jesus. I am a winner. I am an overcomer. In the name of Jesus. Do you believe like you are an overcomer? Do you believe like you are a winner? Hallelujah. God will do it. God will give you grace to win. If you are the one, can I hear a ladder? Amen. Say, God, give me grace to win in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. What the Bible say? Praise the Lord. May my cry come before you, O Lord. Give me understanding according to your word. Give me understanding according. No understanding according to your friend. No understanding according to your experience. Your experience is not the gospel. I can't hear you like that, man. Your experience can be a satanic experience. That's why I pray for you. Every experience of the devil in your life, I remove it in the name of Jesus. May from today, may you see the experience of God. My life, it can't be based on my past. Because my past, there were so many evil ends. My life, it needs to be based on the word of God. God, give me understanding of life. Because my experience can give me a wrong understanding. Give me understanding according to what? To your word. Psalm 119 verse 130. Psalm 119 verse 130. The entrance of God's word, he give what? Light. And he give what? Understanding. Let me say this. The word of God is give you light and understanding. You enter in a business, maybe a business or property. Because of the word of God, God will give you light. He will show you secrets. Things that you never hear from another person, you can hear it from the Holy Ghost. You go, the area is good, you want to buy it, the Holy Ghost is saying, don't put your money in this because this area, you can't make profits. Hallelujah. Because the agent can tell you anything that you want to hear. Because she's looking or he's looking for what? For commission. I pray may God give you understanding. Amen. Secrets. May you see that secret in your business. If you are the one, can I hear a louder amen? Glory be to God. The word of God bring what? Is bring wisdom of God in your life. Wisdom of God in your life. May you see that wisdom. If you are the one, can I hear a louder amen? Psalm 107 verse 20. He sent forth his word. He sent forth his word. And his word delivered them from their grave. There are some people that are walking, but they're in the grave. That's why business is not working for them. You can put money on top of the grave. You'll find that money back. You see? You put, hallelujah, a gold or diamond on top of the grave. Do you think about that dead person who come out? No, it's already gone. There are some people that are in the grave. They need to come out. I come to declare over your life, huh? Every spiritual prison, I take you out from that prison in the name of Jesus Christ. If you are the one, can I hear a louder amen? You are coming out. I say 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 you are coming out. All glory be to God. My business must work. Why? Because I am a child of God. I am blessed with the blessing of Abraham. My father Abraham, hallelujah, was rich, was a champion. He possessed lands. He possessed territory. He raised other people, children. Oh, I can't hear your ladder. Amen. That will be your portion from today. God will give you more than enough. Glory be to God. Not only for you, your children, but even to support other family. If you are the one, can I hear your ladder? Amen. Our God is bigger. And when the wisdom of God is a part of your life, I promise you, you won't make a necessary mistake. A wise person is not a person that, hallelujah, that abuse the things that God gives to him. There are some people, the reason that God does not give them more money, because they abuse when money came to their hand. With no wisdom, they throw it left and right. With no wisdom, they abuse it and their family didn't even enjoy it. And God is saying, I will teach you wisdom before I give you again. It's true. God is not a waster. When he multiplied, remember when Jesus multiplied the bread, the leftover, he didn't say, ah, Peter, throw it in the water. We anyway, collect all. Leftover, collect it all. If you are a waster in one area, I promise you the next miracle will be difficult. That's why God wants us to pay our tithe. I'll give you benefit of paying tithe. Because when you pay your tithes, there is one thing that is happening. First, number one, you will know how much enter in your hands during the week or during the month. That is the first benefit of paying tithe. If I pay under rent, so that means all this week, A thousand enter in my hand. But when you don't pay tithe, it's difficult for you to know how much enter in your hand. And if you like to expand, will be easy. Number two, the reason that you pay your tithe. Hallelujah. Because God wants to put order in your finance. Order in your life. A person that pay tithe is a person that calculates. This is what enter in my hand. This one is belong to God. I have 90%. Okay, from this 90%, I need to pay maybe my bond, or I need to pay school fees. I need to pay food. Okay, I'll remain with this one that I can put some saving in this one, and this one I can. So like when you pay your tithe, there is no disorder in your mind. Order start to enter you. I communicate to somebody. Number three reason that you pay tithe is to involve God in your matter. I hear me, somebody? To involve God in your matter. And when you involve God in your matter, you excel. Number four, reason why you pay your tithes. I communicate to somebody just to make it a little bit easy. Number four, why you pay tithes. Hallelujah. When you pay tithes, hallelujah, that life of having a project, it becomes easy for you. A person that pay tithe is a person that can, hallelujah, make a project. He can plan something and achieve it. Many people, money that enter in your hand from January to December, that you are crying, that money, it could make you already start a business. But you didn't know. Money is coming. Ah, I like these shoes. You buy it. You put it in the house. Ah, I like this one. You didn't pay tithe, so you didn't know how much enter. You're a business person. You make 100 rent. Oh, 10 rent belong to God. This 100 rent, let me put it first on the side. A person that pay tithe is always excel. Think about that. The moment you become serious on paying tithe, there are certain areas that will be easy for you physically. Even spiritually, grace will be with you. Shall we stand because of time? Are you blessed, somebody? Invite somebody this coming Sunday. Don't